Our first module focuses on neuroanatomy and neurophysiology. This module contains a lot of complex terminology, and it would be worth referring back and forth to the glossary as you go through these chapters. The first part of the first module is focused on anatomy and brain development. Now let me define what anatomy means. Anatomy refers to parts of the brain and body, so understanding what those parts are. So for example, you'll learn about cortical sections of the brain known as the lobes. You'll learn about subcortical elements of the brain, for example, the limbic regions. You'll also learn about neurons. Those are nerve cells. So you'll learn about the cellular level of how the brain operates and the different ways the nervous system operates. So that's anatomy, understanding what's involved with parts of the body, okay? Physiology is all about relationships. It's the interactions between different regions of the brain and body, okay? So here we're interested, for example, in cell-to-cell communication, known as neurotransmission. We're interested also in the functioning of the brain and body in synchrony, for example, the autonomic and central nervous system. So you'll learn about, as an example of this, the adrenaline and cortisol systems of the brain and body. One example, that is the HPA or hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis. So that's a definition for you about anatomy and physiology. Let me mention here that neurotransmission is important for you to understand, and it is more complex than you probably have been exposed to in undergraduate studies. So you need to know not just about monoamine neurotransmitters, but also the role of glutamate and glia. So you'll be exposed to that information in this module. I should also mention here that the conclusion of the first part of the first module will introduce a very important neuroeducation tool known as Dan Siegel's hand model. And we'll be practicing this in class so that you can get a sense for how you'd use this with clients. Okay, the second part of the first module is focused on neurophysiological development across the lifespan. We're interested in this part of the module on how the brain develops from the very beginnings of conception throughout the lifespan. It's important for us to understand why survival parts of the brain develop first and the verbal metacognitive parts of the brain develop later. This tends to mirror the evolutionary process by which we've evolved from mammals, other mammals. And so you'll learn about that and how it's understandable why certain parts of the brain develop as they do in human development. It's also important in this section for us to review later adulthood and how neurocognitive disorders develop. You'll learn about tau tangles, amyloid plaques, that kind of stuff, because you'll be working with older adults and being able to understand why the brain works as it does, it will be helpful to you. The third part of this first module will focus on psychopharmacology basics. So here we'll learn about how drugs are absorbed, distributed, metabolized, and excreted from the body, and the effect that they have on the brain and body. We'll learn about neurotransmitters in more depth and neurotransmitters that are linked to mental disorders. So we'll learn about the affective disorders such as anxiety and depression alongside issues like ADHD and the neurotransmitters involved in those mental disorders. And I'll also introduce to you the backwards logic of drug studies and our understanding of mental disorders. In other words, a lot of what we know about the brain actually comes from just sheer happenstance from drug studies. And we'll talk about that. Towards the conclusion of that module, you'll learn about how to talk with prescribers and weave in neuroscience information. This is a really important skill for you to possess as a counselor. In addition to your knowledge of psychopharmacology, which is another topic area entirely, you do need to know how to, again, translate information to prescribers and to clients. And so we'll be talking about how to do that. Towards the conclusion of this, that part of the module, we'll also look at an important case study into the neurological effects of medical conditions and the role of psychiatric medication. So that's our first module on neuroanatomy and neurophysiology.